Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we will study about conjugate hyperbola. The hyperbola whose transverse and conjugate axes are respectively the conjugate and transverse axes of a given hyperbola. Suppose a hyperbola is given, there the conjugate axis will be the transverse axis of this hyperbola and the transverse axis of the given hyperbola will be the conjugate axis of the this hyperbola. Okay, then this type of hyperbola is called conjugate hyperbola of the given hyperbola, and the two hyperbolas are called conjugate hyperbolas. Suppose let us consider the equation of hyperbola, standard form x square by a square minus y square by b square equal to 1. Then we need to find the conjugate hyperbola from this hyperbola. How we will find? See here, what was in the definition here, conjugate was the transverse and transverse was the conjugate. So in place of this x, we will write minus x square by a square, and in place of this y, it will be plus y square by b square equal to 1. And from here, after cancelling the minus, we will get x square by a square minus y square by b square equal to minus 1. So what we can see that the conjugate hyperbola of this equation is equation number 1. Okay, so let us see some properties of conjugate hyperbola. A hyperbola and its conjugate hyperbola have the same pair of asymptotes. The equations of a hyperbola and the conjugate hyperbola can always be so written that they differ from the equation of the asymptotes by the same constant. I will explain this point using example later on. Okay, now just try to understand the statement, the property, the equation of a hyperbola and the conjugate hyperbola differ from the equation of asymptote by simply a constant term. Point number 3, if a pair of diameters be conjugate with respect to a hyperbola, they are also conjugate with respect to the conjugate hyperbola. Number 4, if a diameter meets a hyperbola in real points, it will meet its conjugate hyperbola in imaginary points. Let us see one example. If E and E dash be the eccentricities of a hyperbola and its conjugate, E is for the hyperbola and E dash is eccentricity of the conjugate hyperbola. We need to prove that the inverse of the square of the sum of the eccentricities is equal to 1. So let us take the equation of hyperbola, x square by a square, it will be minus. This will be minus y square by b square equal to 1. Then what is the conjugate of this hyperbola? We simply write in place of x minus x square, and in place of minus y we will write plus y square by b square equal to 1. We are given E and E dash are the eccentricities of this first hyperbola and the second hyperbola respectively. Now for the given for this hyperbola, standard form of hyperbola, we know our relation for that hyperbola. We know this relation, b square equal to a square into a square minus 1. This is the relation of eccentricity for the hyperbola 1. So from here we will find the value of this e square, because in the equation, we need 1 by e square. So from here we will find e square as a square by b, a square plus b square by a square. We will find this one. now we will reciprocal it. It will be a square by a square plus b square. And for the conjugate hyperbola, that means for this equation number 2, what we will do in place of this b, our relation will be in place of b we will write a, and in place of a we will write b. For the conjugate hyperbola, our relation will be this one, a square equal to b square, is it will be e square minus of 1, e dash square, not e square. For the conjugate hyperbola, we were given the eccentricity to be e dash square, so this will be e dash square. So from here we can find e dash square, a square plus b square by a square, and if you reciprocal it, you will get b square by a square plus b square. So you add the two equations 2 and 3, you will get 1. So this was the proof. Okay, so let us take another equation. Find the asymptotes and the conjugate hyperbola of 2xy plus 7x minus 6y minus 18 equal to 0. We already know how to find asymptote of a hyperbola. We will apply the same procedure here also. First write the given hyperbola. Now the equation of the asymptote of this hyperbola differ only by a constant term. So in place of this minus 18, we will write plus lambda equal to 0. Now we will compare this equation with the second degree equation, this one. After comparing, you will get the values of a, h, p, g, f, and c. Now we know that the asymptote is a straight line. So what was the condition for straight line? This was the condition for straight line. You put all the values, you will get the value of lambda to be minus 21. So you put this lambda value in the equation of the asymptote. This will be the combined equation of the asymptote. Now how to find conjugate hyperbola? See here, this one here we have minus 21, okay, and in the given equation of hyperbola we have minus 18. So what is the difference between minus 21 and minus 18? Obviously minus 3 is the difference. If we add 18 minus minus 18 in the equation of hyperbola, it was minus 18. See here, it was minus 18. If you add minus 3 here, we will get minus 21. Minus 21 is the asymptote. This was the asymptote. Here we have minus 21. So we got minus 3 difference. So how we will find the conjugate? We will simply add the minus 3 with the equation of the asymptote. Okay, just see the difference between the constant term of the hyperbola and the asymptote. We have here difference minus 3, so we will add this minus 3 with the equation of the asymptote. We just now find the equation of the asymptote to be this one. You add this minus 3 with this one, you will get the equation of the conjugate hyperbola as this. Here it will be minus 21 minus 3 minus 24. So that only I have written here. We have used the property number 2. We know that the equation of the conjugate hyperbola differs from the equation of the asymptotes by the same constant as the equation of the asymptotes differ from the equation of the hyperbola. If we add the constant minus 3 to the equation of the given asymptote, we get the equation 2 of the asymptote. So adding the constant term minus 3 to the equation 2, that means the equation of the asymptote, we get the equation of the conjugate hyperbola as this one. Okay, so this is the procedure of finding conjugate hyperbola. Next question. Find the equation of the hyperbola whose asymptotes are. Now two asymptotes are given. We need to find the equation of the hyperbola. And and we are also given that it passes through the point 1 minus 1. That means the equation of the hyperbola passes through this point. Now also we need to find the equation of the conjugate hyperbola. Same, using the given hyperbola equation and the asymptote equation, we will find the difference between the constant term, and then whatever will be the difference, we will add the difference with the equation of the asymptote. From there we will find the conjugate hyperbola. So let us start. The combined equation, this was the given equation, this was the given equation of the asymptotes. So combined equation, that means you have to multiply the two equation. After multiplying, you will get this one. This will be the combined equation of the asymptotes. Now from this asymptote, how we will write the equation of hyperbola? We know this one, the equation of hyperbola and its asymptote differ by a constant term. So in place of 15, this is the constant term. So in place of this 15, we will write here lambda. Rest will all be same. So this will be the equation of the hyperbola. And we are given in the question that this hyperbola passes through 1 and minus 1. That means in place of this x we will put 1, and in place of y we will put minus 1. You put this 1 and minus 1 in this equation, you will get the value of lambda to be 7. You put this value of lambda here in equation number 2, we will get the equation of the hyperbola. So we were given two equations of asymptotes. These were the two equations of asymptote. We found the here we found the combined equation of the asymptote to be this one, and our equation of hyperbola to be this one. Now let us check what is the difference between the constant term. Here we have 7, and here in the equation of asymptote we have 15. Now what is the difference? If you add 8 with this 7, we will obviously get 15. This we will get 15. That means our difference between the constant term is 8. So how to, now we will find constant conjugate hyperbola add 8 with this equation. With this equation number 1, we will add the difference. What was the difference? Difference was 8. So with this constant term 15 in the equation of asymptote, we will add the 8. After adding 8, 15 plus 8 will be 23. So let us see what I have written here. Same property number 2 I have written. We know that the equation of the conjugate hyperbola differs from the equation of the asymptotes of the same by the same constant as the equation of the asymptotes differ from the equation of the hyperbola. If we add the constant term 8 to the equation of the hyperbola 3, we get the equation of the asymptote. So adding the constant term 8 to the equation 1 of the asymptotes, the equation of the constant hyperbola is this one. Just add the difference 8 with the equation of the asymptote, you will get 23, and that will be the conjugate hyperbola. Okay, so thank you for today.